family. And so along with your food storage, you need guns and ammo. These things we've been preaching since we've been on the air and since we've been involved in the freedom movement, myself for the last 15 years, maybe a little bit longer. Why they're being so blatant about it right now, I don't know, but the monster is knocking on the door, and we better be ready for it. And there's nobody protecting us in Washington, D.C. Ron Paul would probably be the only one, but he's basically ineffective because he's all by himself. Just like I said before the break, if you think you're going to call your congressman, I get all these emails all the time, call your congressman, call your senator, and ask him not to do this bill or whatever. Those are all jokes, Alex. I do not waste my time trying to call my congressman or senator anymore. Those guys are bought and paid for. They're going to do what they're going to do. They do not care about you. They do not care about their constituents. And there is one person who I believe can stop this new world order. His name is your county sheriff. And that's why I've written the new book, The County Sheriff, America's Last Hope. It details the documentation. There is no question that your sheriff has the responsibility to protect you from tyranny.
And that's why the feds,
bankers, whatever. Yes, go ahead.
That's why the feds have been moving, and in many states, to abolish the sheriff or make it be appointed by the city when it's the county chartered by the state. And he is the elected, most powerful elected representative in the county. Literally, he can, call up a posse, the local draft. It's totally constitutional. Instead, they've tried to shut down the sheriff, demonize it, or run feds and New World Order people for the position. So they've been attacking it from every angle, weakening it, getting rid of it, making it appointed, not elected. I think the best way to start here is
just... You're right. They've already stopped. They've already done away with the sheriff in Connecticut. And you were talking about the immigration problem, not the immigration problem, but the illegal immigration problem. Sheriff Joe Arpaio, who has endorsed my book, by the way, he's on the back of the book. He believes in all of this about the autonomy of the sheriff. Look what he has done. He has been, I guess, the only sheriff in this country to round up illegals and arrest them and take them and put them in jail. And he's having the feds come and get them as soon as they can and say, look, I'm doing your job here. Come and get them and send them back. This is an amazing example of your sheriff. Have you noticed that nobody can get in his way? He even had the city of Mesa, where he was doing some raids there, and he actually went into the city of Mesa building and arrested some illegal aliens in the city complex. And the chief of police got real mad and was spouting off on the news about Sheriff Arpaio should be coordinating such an effort with him. And then they interview Arpaio, of course, and you know what he said. The last time I looked, Mesa is within the jurisdiction of Maricopa County. He says, I don't have to ask anybody's permission. And that's the point I make in the book. Your sheriff is not a bureaucrat. He does not answer to anyone except the people. And he's bound by oath to uphold and defend the Constitution. And therefore, he can protect you from the IRS. He can protect you and your money, your property, your welfare, your children. He is the only answer left. The county sheriff, America's last hope. That's
at the county level, but there's also juries, grand juries, that form of voting for the people is another hope. And we now have 10 states and 20 others now saying they may sign on to declare sovereignty, and in the bills that I've been reading the last few days on air, we've had some state reps on, it states we will not have martial law, we will not have gun confiscation, we will not have forced compulsory service, and they list what the feds are doing. And so the state is the answer, and enshrined in that, the smallest unit of that is the sheriff.
Right.
And you're right, I've seen cases all over the country where they're trying to come repossess people's homes.
Right.
And the sheriff saying no. So that's why they tried to move to block the sheriff and basically federalize the states, because originally, in how our country's set up, it is the state that is the true unit of power.
It is. And, and the county even more powerful than that, I do believe. And in the book, you'll see the documentation from my lawsuit that you mentioned when you introduced me. The lawsuit is key to all of this because it establishes the constitutional premise for the sheriff to have this power, and it's backed up by a recent Supreme Court ruling, which came out in June of 1997. This has not been rescinded. It's law, and Justice Scalia details quite clearly that the federal government has no power over the county or the county sheriff or the state employees.
Instead, under Obama, they're trying to federalize everything. They're building FEMA camps where the local sheriff offices out of it with the military, with the police, and with clergy response teams. Can you speak to that?
Well, yes. You know, those are happening, it appears. I haven't seen any here in Arizona yet, but it doesn't matter where they're going up. If they're going up one place, they're going to be going up in others. I've maintained, even when I was sheriff, and I maintain even now, that the sheriff can tell FEMA to stay out of his county. We can make our own preparations. And the typical example of this is the failure of the federal government, especially during Hurricane Katrina, to really help people. And people have their hands out and expect the federal government to come take care of you. Don't expect it, don't count on it, and don't even want it.
Well, FEMA, as you know,
your own preparations at the county level, and just do your own. Look what they did also at Katrina. They started taking everybody's guns away from them.
That's what I was going to say is
self-defense.
Finally, the parish sheriff, not a county, a parish there, had to go stop FEMA from cutting the police communication lines because they wanted total federal control.
Of course, and they're going to, and if we continue to allow it, and if we have sheriffs who aren't aware of their duty, then this is going to continue to happen. I mean, you can look at the problems that happened when sheriffs relinquished at Ruby Ridge, at Waco, at New Hampshire with the Elaine, what was her last name?
Edna Lane Brown.
Yeah, exactly, the Brown family. I mean, every place where the sheriff, and I think these were good sheriffs and good people there, they just are ignorant of the power and authority they have. The federal government has no jurisdiction in your county to be doing these things unless you, as the sheriff, allow it. And yes, you can go along, but to do so means you're throwing your constituents to the dogs. And this needs to be turned around, and I do believe that this book will offer the proper documentation and proof positive that the sheriff is the ultimate authority, and we need to educate him about that. I believe if we put the right information in front of the sheriffs in this country, we'll have them convinced. Can you imagine you can get freedom back and kick out the New World Order all at the same time by getting your sheriff on board?
Well, here's
there's only 3,000 sheriffs in this country. And if we could get 300 or 400 of them on board, just get 10% on board, the rest of it will snowball, or you could move to where one of them, who actually is a constitutional sheriff.
And this idea is spreading thanks to you and others, rediscovering liberty in our true system of government. A microcosm is studying the Western expansion, the robber barons, the oil companies, the coal companies, the railroads.
Yeah.
They would come in and buy off a sheriff and use him to let the Pinkerton and others go in and slaughter people and kick them off their land. But in more cases than not, it was the people sheriff that would fight off the bankers. So we've gone through this before.
Yes, we have. And, you know, I really feel that the time is ripe because of the hopelessness that people felt during especially this last campaign. The presidential election, I think, left so many people with a bad taste in their mouth of hopelessness. And right now, I'm given a message that there is hope, and it is your county sheriff.
Absolutely, ladies and gentlemen. Final segment with Sheriff Richard Mack straight ahead after this quick break and his new book. We'll talk about that as well.
This year, many of us will have to make the tough decision on what to cut back on and what's essential as we prepare for an uncertain future. In these troubled times, one of the most important things your family can have is good health. Some of the contributors to poor health are parasites, viruses, toxins, and heavy metals. It's a documented fact. 80% of all Americans and 85% of people around the world suffer from internal parasites and parasitic infection. Now you can fight internal parasites, heavy metals, and high high cholesterol naturally and safely by mixing fossilized phytoplankton powder, also known as FPP, with your favorite beverage once a day. FPP is now available to you from freshwaterorganics.com. A 2-month supply starts at just $17. FPP is so affordable, you can't afford to do without. Visit freshwaterorganics.com or call them toll-free at 888-949-3570. That's 888-949-3570.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this